Got a checkup.
You hanging in there?
Not bad, not good. Coming to terms, I suppose.
Okay. Really hadn't planned on recording this one, but look where the rogue robots are. Okay, I think that's just the marker for the mechanized lair, but look at this. Right next to the heavily fortified Croup Manor. Let's take a look.
One grim locale.
Yeah, it is. Everybody sleeping? Everybody, is there anybody here? There's supposed to be 13 people. Where the heck are they? Look at how many beds they put in. Enough. I need some health anyway. Let's take a nap. Nice long nap. Okay, now. A little more luck here. Come on, let's... Let's see how this works. Did you get them all? Maybe not. There's a lot of bad things on this island. And I don't have a whole lot of problem with just blasting the crap out of most of the stuff here. As long as it's not Croup Manor. If they get some tossle towards Croup Manor, well, that would just be a wild thing to see. There's only one left, so what we can do a hack. Initiate the self-destruct. Well, I'm standing back. And we got the glow. Rogue robot. It can be just that simple if you're in the right position. Let's go see what's left. Might be some stuff to shoot at, but... Eh, that's only fair. I will say, I do very much like the way the Radiant Quest with the mechanists work. It seems like they've learned a lot from the feedback on the other Radiant Quest. You have to go to her to get the quest. You can wait all day to go get the quest. They're not just going to appear, they're not going to interrupt what you're doing. And when they're done, you get rewarded. Just look at the spark. RoboBrain front actuated frames. Let's see, now, the one thing about doing this is the one way you can save a lot on building robots, because rebuilding robots is really expensive unless you have the parts. Like there's a lot of stuff going on here. Okay, integrated back. Okay, that might have been from before. Oh, that's the Quantum RoboBrain that gave us the first, stuff. Ah, looks like there was settlers. Oh, well now how do you handle it? Because if it incited them to kill the settlers, blasting the crap out of settlers, maybe we want to rethink this. Let's give it a shot. Okay, now this is just an experiment to see if by taking the easy way out, we just killed a couple of settlers, you know? Excuse me. And we know where they are. Now, what if we rush in to be the hero? He's already shooting at them. Well, I died, so... maybe the easy way out wasn't a bad plan. Okay, there is another method here. It might actually even be quicker. Rather than incite, lock him up. Come on, we know he's right around here. There's one. Where's the tank bot? Come on. Hack. Hack, you bastard. Not getting in there where I can hack him. Come on, why not? Maybe I should just take the settler's stuff. I mean, you know. The one I want. I shut her down. I still don't know what the limitations on hacking are. Is it a range? It's obviously not a range thing. Okay, now hack. Getting killed. Oh, good. Hope this works. Yay. Inventory. Let's get some... question. I don't see dead settler. Yeah, there's at least one dead settler. And upstairs. And another dead settler, I think. Oh, goodness. You know what? The settlers were screwed anyway. That's kind of clear, no matter what I did here. The settlers were definitely attacked. If anything, the other way it might have even been better. Same dead settlers. And I did everything I could there. I've tried rushing in, I've tried rushing out. Alright, let's just load. Do I have that? I need to save. So, this is, well, the best I could do. Yeah, in the tradition of the Commonwealth, leave all naked dead, and yeah, no, all dead naked, or in their underwear, riding where they are. That is the one, you know, perhaps inaccurate thing about the whole experience is. I don't think I got as good of parts this time. But I wouldn't have taken a lot of this stuff if they weren't dead, so. But at least, you know, we can say, well, we tried this multiple ways. And, you know, it just goes to show you, sometimes I wondered, I mean, when you cause them to incite, do they go just after, is it just disable their inhibitors, so they go after everybody? Like the people they were gonna go after anyway, or do they go to your side? What we're gonna do, there's that original RoboBrain, and don't worry, they're gonna look spectacular soon. Spectacular, I tell you. This is a Protectron head with a. That's an. Oh, that looks like it's the. It's too bad you can't. No point in wasting ammo on him. We should run. That was very Michael Bay there, Nick. Very nice. Plus 86 experience. All you get is experience. Get the same hydraulic frame. I would have liked the gun. That would have been. It's too bad you can't, like, shut them down and then scrap them completely. Just take it home for scrap. Still another day on the sad island. Have Croup Manor. What's in here? Might as well do a little exploration, especially since those things around here are killing everything. A basketball. Yeah, you kind of need those. Rubber becomes more important once you get the, once you get to start building robots. Glowing fungus. Burnt textbooks. Burnt books. I don't know why the burnt textbooks are miscellaneous, are they not just a burnt book? Is there anything special about that church? That's Mike Lark eggs. There is something special about this church. Yep! Let's move. We're running backwards. Come on, Nick. I want to kite him. Run away, run away, run away. This is a long distance thing, if ever. Nick is probably being eaten alive by a microqueen. If Nick's not going to run away with me, then can we see it from here? Yep, we can. Let's... come on. Block this way.
No.
I heard Nick. Yes! Come on, come in range of the missiles. Oh dear, they're going out.
Killing one piece.
Did they drop it? Or did Nick drop it? Yeah, Nick's pretty capable. Did it get stuck in the trees? Good job, Nick. Put it right around.
Toss anything you can't haul my way.
That was nice of him. Bayoneted heavy sniper rifle. Sturdy combat armor chest piece. I said, ate somebody with a sturdy. Look at that, it actually got stuck in the trees. Well, this is kind of cool because there is a kick your eggs. There is an achievement for killing a certain number of like huge beasts. That's just spooky. Dead fish, yucky. So I can rack that up pretty handily, just respawning this sucker. Ooh, you know what? I wonder if you can capture one of those when we get the Wasteland, what you call workshop perk thing. There's only two things I really am interested in the Wasteland workshop. I'm not planning on setting up a Thunderdome. I could, but I'm not. Ooh, here we found another one. Their mechanist holotape. Poor mechanist, she's so misunderstood. And that was the house we just went through. There are probably some ghouls around here. At some point. Did we get through him? Yeah, we killed him a long time ago, but they don't rot. It does seem to litter the landscape. They're dead settler from another time. Again, not a happy island. But so the one thing I'd like to try and catch behemoths, specifically Swan. Now, what's in the Nahant Oceanological Society? Oceanological stuff? Well, first of all, I'm expecting stuff to try to kill me. Maybe not, but...
You know, I can probably make that terminal talk for you, if you ask nicely.
I could do it, too. Hard wipe type. It's a hard wipe type. User Jim Prescott signed in an internal memo. We will be shutting down for the last week of October while the bulk of our staff is in Monterey for the National Aquatic Protection Symposium. I'll be remaining here to continue preparation for the harbor blockade to protest the war the first week of November. And remaining staff members, please use the week to coordinate with volunteers to get more sign-ups for the blockade. I'll be working out of the research lab this week if you need to find me. Dr. Casey Reed. How much you want to bet he's a glowing one? Please, Jim, please remember to power down the robots before you leave for the weekend. How much you want to bet they didn't power down the robots? I've, this is one thing, I'm going here completely blind. I haven't looked anything up. We at the Luchological Society will strive to save our oceans. Blah, 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 blah. Well, after dumping radioactivity into the sea, and you can imagine a world where we were using strictly...
To a length of over a meter, the GUI duck is the world's largest clam. They can live for over 150 years.
Talk about collecting dust.
Okay, so we do have robots in action here. Toasters. Stuff we need. We need junk. We need lots of junk. Ooh, Vol-Tec lunchbox and a plastic knife or something. Hooray for Vol-Tec lunchboxes.
Growing to a length of over a meter, the GUI duck is the world's largest clam. They can live for over 150 years.
It's the Wasteland Survival Guide!
Excellent.
10% discount from food and drink vendors. The Commonwealth coupon spectacular. That's wonderful. Give me your typewriter. All your shit. I will talk to you in a little while after I take all of your stuff. Take your stuff. Phone. Love phones. Phones got, you know, they work for me. Lighters, all expensive stuff.
Welcome to the Nahad Oceanological Society.
He noticed me. And now you know how to say it. There's a desk with nothing in it. A lantern. Lantern will have oil. That's good. Surgical tray and a fish.
Welcome to the Nahad Oceanological.
We got multiples. We got dead fish. We got a little boat. Microscope. That's a big deal. Leave the dead fish. Take the rest of the stuff. Bunsen burner should have some oil. Glue.
Welcome to the Nahad Oceanological System.
An expert lock. These are going to be harder since I took off that leg piece or whatever it is. Okay, I got lots of bobby pins. Next perk, I think I'll put in, well, I don't know, I might end up putting it into blacksmith just so I can build more robots. This is a particularly hard lock. Even for an expert. There you go.
Got it.
This looks kind of neat, because it seems like it's more of a classic. Go through everything, take everything, nothing necessarily going to kill you, kind of thing.
Dream big, buddy.
Don't be afraid to dream big. Okay, don't worry, I'm going to be dumping most of this on you in a minute. A vase, an alarm clock.
Welcome to the Nahad Oceanological Society.
Thank you. Where is... There you are. Having a seat. Kicking back a little. I don't blame you.
Hey, do something for you?
Trade.
Here's what I've got.
Here's what you got. Guess what you're gonna get. Lots of junk. Something tells me I bought a bunch of stuff and they didn't dump it off. All the stuff from the mechanist. I forgot to dump it in the, in the workshop there. Fuse and a subway token. Oh, look, a wall safe. That was quick, but it's got some kind of anti-bobby pin. This is only an advanced lock. We're almost there. There you go.
That's it.
Bullets, bottle cap, metal arms, and stuff. Over at the Narwhal and Oceanological Society, they expected trouble. Yeah, that's... 7 bottle caps. A camera.
Welcome to the Nahad Oceanological Society.
Yes.
Welcome to the Nahad Oceanological Society.
That's all you say?
Welcome to the Nahad Oceanological Society.
I could shut him down and blow him up and take his stuff. But I have a real issue just blowing up harmless stuff. Just to, you know, we'll let these guys go on for the millennia, welcoming people. I'm okay with that.
Welcome to the Nahad Oceanological Society. Welcome to the Nahad Oceanological Society.
It's pleasant, you know? There's some stuff through here.
A little collection or something?
Heck yeah. That's right. Right now I'm just kicking back at the... Oceanological Society, it's just... Pen. Nothing in the desk. Take the... Building a collection. Building a robot. Why would they have EC charges? Yeah. This is like somebody was using this as a hold-up point. Yeah! Were we protected in there? Or will we go back in and we'll be all radioactive? Oh. We are protected from the rad storm. So this is like a solid building enough that you could it'll actually keep you safe. Oh, we found one more thing to loot anyway.
Sweet.
Good things. You know how I love purified water.
When was the last time someone came through here?
The bathroom? I don't know. Oh, a flag. And can we get that? Might as well wait now, or now we're just going to sit here for a little while.
Welcome to the Nahad Oceanological Society. Welcome to the Nahad Oceanological Society.
Let's find somewhere comfortable. Shall we? First of all, yeah, that's just... I'm just gonna have a seat. Then we're gonna wait an hour. 2 hours. Until the radiation storm passes.
Don't be afraid to drink.
To dream, there you go. Dream big. Okay. Whoa. I knew there'd be something. There's always something. Stuff underneath us. That doesn't open? That seems like an oversight. There must be mic lurks underneath us or something like that. Let's go back inside the Oceanological Society. Nahant? Is it Nahant? The Lost Patrol. Oh, I'm not going to do the Lost Patrol. I drifted into the Lost Patrol.
Out.
Single out? What did he say? Okay. That was weird. What the heck? Where the heck was I expected some kind of resistance here? You can see mic lurks around. Anything interesting out on that boat? Well, I mean, I know if I go past the boat, I'm in Mike-Lurk land. What's this building? Oh, the research lab. What were they researching? First of all, there's probably a glowing one in here. That's a pretty extensive lab for like a little oceanological society. We may have to come back here, and I don't want to sit down. No, get up, get up, get up, get up, get up. Yeah, take the turpentine and then get up. Get, stand the heck up before something stabs you in the neck. Or bites you in the neck.
What the hell aroma is that?
Probably dead fish. Oh my word.
That's one way to get that coolant pumping.
You know, it was for just these sort of things that I got my penetrating hardened automatic for. And I'm not saying it'll do as well as my trusty dusty two-shot, because the trusty dusty two-shot, that's just an awesome piece of equipment. It just is. Lantern and a machete and stuff and bullets. You know, if you really like those ammo cans too, you know you can buy those all over the place. Almost any gun show. I'm glad I'm Aqua Boy. Ooh, microscope. Oh, great. I'm carrying too much and can't run, and he's carrying too much and can't run. But there's a research facility, more microscopes.
I wouldn't.
Casey Reed. Lobster growth. That's funny. Did you leave them in the ship again? Ah, so there's keys in the ship.
Without a dose of Radex first.
Oh yeah, I wouldn't drink any of it either. Well, here's the trick. It's going to be a nice slow walk back to, back to Croup Manor. Someone took down the oceanological instructor and there's nothing in him. You might say, why don't you just dump some of this off so you can walk faster and fast travel a little bit? And I very well may. This is kind of neat, you know, from the perspective that, for the most part in this game, you know, this is a nice little bit of normal scavenging, as opposed to having to deal with overwhelming odds. You know, one Mike-Lurk, oh, they're nasty if you don't have the right weapons, don't get me wrong. But it's not 10 Mike-Lurks. A master lock. What's in this trunk that requires a master lock? I can buy bobby pins all over the place.
nice.
If I ever get low, chem station. The keys to his office, what does that mean? Probably means that's keys to an office I've already opened. It's times like this I think I should put enough perks into the strong back, the strong back perk so that I could fast travel while encumbered. That does help. Did you hear that? So obviously we're going to look at the boat at some point when we feel like shooting a bunch of Mycolars, which reminds me. This was kind of a nice little burst of just scavenging, doing a little bit of shooting stuff up, but nothing ridiculous. Well, we did have a Mycolar Queen, but we kited that right into the crew of Manor guns, and that was useful enough. I wonder what's out there. Should check that out at some point. They leave more and more scattered dead robots as things go on. There she is, Croup Manor, the creepiest place on the isle. It's such a long walk. But it's gonna be so worth it when I get here. What are you hot? What? Interesting commentary, my friend. Give me your junk.
Hey, what's the plan?
So much junk. A clean pepper mill. Mm. Note to self. Make sure that when you buy junk, you get rid of it before you do anything else. That's a lot of junk. 482 pounds. And there's your difference. And on this note, looking at this glorious workshop, I shall end this video. This is the Black Knight. Have a great night, everybody.